Out of that developing story right out of Houston, rapper Takeoff, best known for being a member of the Grammy Award-winning group Migos, has died. The 28-year-old, whose real name is Kishnet Kari Ball, was shot and killed overnight in Houston while attending a private party at a bowling alley.
Takeoff's lawyer just sent us this statement saying, quote, along with my firm, I'm devastated by the tragic death of Kishnet Ball, known to his fans as Takeoff. Takeoff was not only a brilliant musical artist with unlimited talent, but also a uniquely kind and gentle soul. He will be greatly missed now and always. Well, the news is just shaking the hip-hop community, the music community across the country. And for more, let's bring in Jewel Wicker, Atlanta-based entertainment and culture reporter, and A.R. Shaw, author of Trap History, Atlanta Culture, and the Global Impact of Trap Music. Thanks for both of you for joining us on this tough news. A.R., just tell us a little bit. Give us the background of the impact that Takeoff and Migos has made in hip-hop, in the music world, specifically trap music.
Definitely. Takeoff was somewhat of the glue of Migos. A lot of people don't know this, but early on, Quavo was a star quarterback in high school, and also Offset played football. Takeoff was the one who actually got into the music first, and he got them to join, and they created great music, starting in 2011, coming out with the signature album Culture in 2016, where it pretty much reshaped the hip hop community. So it's not just, you know, a loss for the Atlanta community. This is something that's global, that's impacting the hip hop community worldwide.
So Jewel, let me just follow up on that. You know, Takeoff is known for being very laid back, not in the press very much, but a lot of people will argue that lyrically, you know, he was the best in the group. And you even tweeted, his uncle, Quavo, also a member of the group, even agreed with that, saying how his sound helped shape the music that we hear today. Tell us more.
That's right. I interviewed Quavo earlier this year, and he told me, you know, Takeoff is easily the strongest rapper of the group. He also, just like AR said, told me how Takeoff was the one that got him into rapping, and Takeoff got his name because he could record his raps in one single take and didn't have to re-record them. So, I mean, really was the background of the group. And I think even if you asked his group members, they would say that he was the stronger lyricist of the group.
And AR, you wrote this book on trap music, you know, from the north side of Atlanta there. One of your chapters, our producers noticed, called How Migos Culture Album Changed the Culture of Trap Music. What do you mean by that? Tell us.
So they introduced what is called the triplet rhyme scheme. And it's a rhyme pattern that has been duplicated by artists such as Jay-Z, Drake, J Electronica. You can hear the triplet rhyme scheme throughout many artists' music. And it started with this generation, with the Migos. And so when you talk about Culture, the Culture album, they shifted culture in a way that was a phenomenon, where you saw, you know, individuals copy not just the way that they rap, but also their music as well. So they had a tremendous impact in the hip hop community as well. When you think about trap music, Atlanta music, and just the culture in general.
A.R. Shaw, Jewel Wicker, appreciate you both. Thank you so much. It's been hard to even confirm this story, so you rolled with us for a number of hours. Thanks for being with us. Appreciate it.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.